So I wake up to make coffee and I look in the and the door's open. He's not there. I'm like looking around. I'm like, oh my God, he leave in the middle of the night to meet his girlfriend. Like I just immediately think like that.
You're listening to What a Joke with Papa and Fortune.
Welcome back, everybody. What a Joke with Papa and Fortune. We're very excited. Our good friend Heather McDonald is here. She's here.
She looks gorgeous.
She looks amazing.
Thank you. I was just saying, I want you guys to go on and say Heather was the best dressed comic that we've had on the show so far. I know the show's been on that long.
100%.
Yeah. No. I would like to have
everyone
that award.
Everyone comes in jeans and t-shirts, so you're killing it.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You look amazing.
Pink.
Because Fortune and I were essentially married.
Yeah.
For,
right.
Yeah.
For about 3 years.
She tried to turn me into a gay man. All of a sudden, I was watching housewives shows and talking about, you know, whatever, gossip magazine.
I remember the moment you realized I had turned you. And we had a really great caterer. So every day we'd have lunch, you know, and there was always like a great dessert. And sometimes I'd eat the dessert. I'd have a couple bites and I'd be like, not worth the calories. Like, unless it's going to really like feel like heroin in your veins. Like, why would you bother with like some sad, dry, like carrot cake? So I threw it away. And then one day Fortune took a bite of something and she's like, not worth the calories.
Oh.
Something I've never said in my entire life. I would eat any sugar, anything. It didn't matter how stale or old it was.
Sure.
All of a sudden, I'm like, not worth the calories. And then I stopped myself and was like, what did I just say? Oh, my God. So she has
changed.
I don't know what. Now Tom's essentially my office mate.
I know. That's okay. That's great. I love it.
How do you guys feel? Or do you guys feel okay? Is this...
I'm okay with it.
Just like any other.
I'm fine.
Okay.
Look, it's like relationships happen and they have a beginning and an end.
Yeah.
And sometimes they're in your life for a season. Sometimes they're in there for a reason. And you are both. So I'm okay with you moving on with other relationships.
That's generous of you.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
Tom's wife is getting a little jealous.
Oh, she is.
That's some juicy scoop.
Tell
right
me
there.
About that. Well, that's the kind of stuff I love in my show. Anything about cheating, jealousy. people will like post like a text exchange or a weird story. Like, is this weird that they're not, that my husband says I can't go on the company thing this weekend? You know, things like that.
Oh, yeah. Tell me
about Juicy Scoop.
Juicy Scoop is a podcast I started I think it's been over 3 years, and has it been 4 years?
I thought so.
Okay, I don't know. It's been a really long time. It's been a long time, but it was one of those things that, you know, 4 years ago or whatever it was when I started it, I just kind of was like, oh, all right, I guess it's time to have a podcast. Like, I've got nothing else going on. And and then I'd like...
And I don't want to be around my kids all day.
Yeah, and so I was like, oh, this is fun. This, like, gives me a little more structure because Fortune and I met on Chelsea lately. So for so many years, I every day was at a TV show writing, had to, you know, be there from 9 to 6 or whatever.
Right.
And so, and then I just... It was, like, shocking, like, that... I didn't understand like how, because it wasn't reflecting my social media and I didn't know how many people were listening and I almost didn't want to know. I was just like, let me, and it was really great. And then I just got, it was just, I was getting all these new listeners and new people that would then come to the live shows. And then it just kind of became this big thing for me. And so hopefully it's been really fun for everybody else, but I love doing it. I mean, it's a lot because I do it all myself.
So it took off. But it wasn't reflecting on your social media. But
not,
it was just...
not right away, yeah.
So who's the audience?
So it's mostly, it's like 85% or 84% women.
Right.
It's a great audience. It's a really smart audience. And oftentimes, because I talk about some reality shows and Bravo type of stuff,
right,
I got this audience that wasn't that familiar with stand-ups. And then by having like Fortune and other comedians that are my friends come on, they're all like my show sometimes was the first time they've ever been to a comedy club.
Oh, interesting.
And then they absolutely like are obsessed and they start, you know, loving all my friends and they make sure that, you know, they go to their shows when they come to town. And so it's just anything juicy. So it's predominantly funny, but once in a while, if something really juicy is going on, I'm like, you know, let's talk about it.
And she'll get text messages from fans being like, I was dating a guy and this is what happened. Now, you know, and, right. and can you guys dissect this yeah. text conversation?
Yeah. Please then, give me some help.
Yeah.
What's going on with your
wife?
So
tell Heather what's happening.
It's not a big deal. You're just kind of starting to see like little rumblings. Like she's all of a sudden is like, well, I'd really like to meet Fortune. I was like, yeah, okay, eventually. No, I just think, you know, you're spending a lot of time with her. It'd just be good that if I met her. And I'm like, oh, this is the same thing she does when she gets jealous of people.
That's
and
amazing.
And she's not really letting it go.
So you have a little bit of a jealous wife.
A little bit.
I have the complete opposite.
Oh, really?
Yes. My husband, we've been married 19 years, is the most unjealous person on earth.
Really?
Yes. Like I've tried.
Is that because he's cheating?
No. I never let myself think that he couldn't cheat.
Right.
So I always think of the worst case scenario. Like I come home, you know, before I got home, like I'd be driving home and I'd be like, what if I go in the house and shower's running at 2 in the afternoon and it's Peter and his best friend Bill just going down on each
Bill.
Other.
Oh,
I imagine the worst thing. So that way if I see it, I won't have a stroke and die. So this morning
I like that you went to Bill, not like a Carrie here. Yeah.
Well, I think of that too, but I also think of like don't be shocked. You know,
okay.
Everyone's always like, oh, I was so shocked.
Yeah, what's the most shocking thing?
So this morning I'm like, you know, we have it. My daughter's room is a nice big room and she's in college. So I'm like, you know, I have to wake up really early to do Fortune's show. So just, you know, let me like turn on the lights. And so he's in the other room. So I wake up to make coffee and I look in the door's open. He's not there. I'm like looking around. I'm like, oh my God, he leave in the middle of the night to meet his girlfriend. Like, I just immediately think like that. And then I go to the kitchen. And
19
we have
years.
Yeah, we have a little bathroom off the kitchen.
Yeah.
And I'm ready. I'm accepting it. Before I even feed the cat, I'm like, well, now we know the truth. Now we know that you leave in the middle of the night to sleep with your girlfriend.
Or Bill.
Yeah, or Bill. And he just comes out of the bathroom. He's like, hey. I'm like, oh. Well, thank God. What are you trying to do to me before I do Fortune shows?
You're just trying to keep things spicy over there.
Has he ever given you reason to think?
Like never.
Never cheated, never anything.
Never, ever. Yeah, but right. I don't like to get, you know, I don't
complacent.
Like, I always feel like there's always those women that are so confident. Like I always would see,
right.
Like I'd always see, you know, a lot of like talk show hosts, you know,
uh-huh. yeah.
would be like, not my man. And like, all, and everyone's like, oh, you guys are so great. And then it'd be like, they were married to the worst man ever. So I'm always like, marriage is okay.
Right.
Not that great. You know, like, yeah. just so then that way, you know, it won't be a huge shock.
Keep your expectations
yeah,
in check.
Keep it low. But like one time I was like, he was on like a business thing, and he was, you know, dealing with this little rental house we had, and he was supposed to come home on a Wednesday. So we're talking right. Tuesday night, and he goes, you know what, I think I'm going to have to stay till Friday. And I go, okay. So then so then I hung up, and I was like, you know how people always get caught for cheating because they send a text to their spouse accidentally. Like, they meant to send it to their lover. That's how a lot of people get caught cheating.
Right.
It's on Dateline all the time.
Yeah, totally. And you do it sometimes. You're like, oh, sorry, not for you, you know?
Yeah.
So I texted my husband, and I just wrote, I waited like a couple minutes, and then I just wrote, oh, hey, he's not going to be home until Friday now. Just to see what Peter would do.
No.
What was this? Yes. And then nothing. Doesn't even respond. So then I like took a photo of just like my cleavage. With, like, I like put my cat under there to like just really get him up there. And I just sent that. Like, missing you, you know? Uh-huh. And he's nothing. And so then I wrote him a third time. And I go, hey, sorry. Those weren't for you. And he calls me. He's like, what is wrong with you? Like, why can't you be jealous like a normal person? Like, what do you? I'm on the road. Like, there's nothing I do that, you know. But as a female comic, we don't, like, male comics, and definitely not you.
Yeah.
Male comics, whether they're married or in a relationship, we all know many of them have fooled around on the road.
Right.
Okay, sorry to break things, but it happens. Right. But it's like, as women, what am I going to be? Trolling for fresh dick after, you know, three shows? No. Like, I'm like, what, am I going to take someone home and, like, possibly be murdered? No, you're just like, just get me home. Let me lock
possibly
the door.
Be murdered.
Yeah, like, we don't do that, you know?
Well,
so.
It's interesting you bring up the text thing, because I did, I had a text that I wrote to Fortune.
Oh.
When I said, I'll see you tomorrow, honey buns. And I sent it to Cynthia by mistake. So maybe that's what that started
it. That might have triggered everything.
But so you have not revealed that Fortune is engaged to a woman. She still thinks there's a chance that you are so sexy that Fortune's going to leave her fiance and start going for you.
Yeah. I just think she thinks like you, like anything's possible.
Right.
So until she meets Fortune and looks her in the eyes.
Oh.
And tries to intimidate her. She won't
rest.
She's got
to mark her man.
Yes. Yeah. Okay.
You know?
Yeah.
Mark her territory.
Yeah. I think that she's done this before with, even like with guy friends. She thinks you have like a little crush just as a friend thing.
Yeah.
And she'll be like, it's so weird that you're spending a lot of time with Colin. That's really strange. And I'll be like, well, we're just comedians hanging out. I don't know. What, are you going out or something?
I have my best friend since I was 14. Okay. We talk all the time.
Yeah.
And we talk all the time. And there just started to come a time that even like the kids were like, Tara's calling so much, Tara. And I'm like, so finally I did what people do when they cheat. And I changed her name in my phone to William Morris Agent. She was calling so much. My family thought I was like working on like a Paramount takeover deal. They're like, what? God, things are going great for you. William Morris is just calling you all the time.
Oh my God.
I remember you had a show that I loved about like marriage.
Yeah, the marriage ref.
And I thought that was so great because I'm like, whenever you get in a fight with your spouse, your boyfriend, or your girlfriend, sometimes you're just like, I know if there was a jury here, I know if people saw this, they would be on my side. But nobody's here to judge it.
It was a great premise.
Yes.
That you have to bring a third party in to solve these marital fights. It's so perfect. It was a really, for me, that was there was a lot of things that worked and a lot of things that didn't work about the show. But for me, the best part was the couples.
Yeah.
The celebrities, it was kind of fun. It was a novelty. But dealing with like a couple, a real couple that was just fighting to the death about throw pillows.
Yeah.
That to me was just so much fun.
Yeah.
Because there's so many things where as you know, in a relationship for a long time, you're just like, you know, okay, when do I give up? And you're constantly like changing your negotiations.
What's worth it?
And then there's this new time as I get older. And now I'm like, I don't care. I can afford it. Whatever. And so then my kids will be like, Mom's rich. She's doing this. Because I'm like, for so long, I felt like, God, you know, I don't want to go to Dave and Buster's on my birthday. Like, I want to do what I want to do. Like,
you work
so
hard.
Many things that I did to do whatever the kids wanted, you know, and whatever my husband wanted. And
now,
so,
you're feeling yourself.
Oh, my God. My sister and I, the kids had different spring breaks. So
how
my
old
sister,
are your kids?
They're 16 and 13.
Okay.
And my stepdaughter is a sophomore in college. But the two boys had different spring breaks because one's in Catholic and one's in public, and they never give them the same break because they don't want them to know each other.
Right.
So they're like, I go, great. So I said, so my sister who is Catholic kids, I go, do you want to take, I'll take my one Catholic kid and you take your one.
Right.
And we'll just go on a spring break together. Just, oh my God. It was the greatest week of my life. It was like, I'm like, now I understand about Oprah and Gail. Everyone thought they were lesbians.
Oh, with your best friend?
I'm like, they weren't lesbians. They just were like, fuck, we're 50. Leave me the fuck alone. Like, they're just so happy.
I was
like,
let me be with my best friend.
Yes. And then, so I'm like, so we, you know, we had got a condo, which my husband found, which is a great condo, like on the beach. And then I was like, you know what, Shannon, my sister, I go, we don't have to stop at Costco in Maui. Why do we have to go to Costco? Why don't we just go out to eat this entire trip? Like, why do I have to go to Costco? And then I started, so all these things.
So all the stuff you would do with your husband.
All these things. That, I was like, oh my God, I don't want to cook. I don't want 12 pounds of pokey that I'm going to feel guilty about if we don't finish. I want to have the option of just going out and eating every meal. Like, it's a vacation. The freedom.
Yeah.
Welcome. You should be a lesbian.
That's why I love late in life lesbians. I think
late life lesbians.
I think it's a great way to go.
I am married, though, to a man, to clarify. And here's the thing. My ring is fancy, right? My ring is fancy, but I'm not fancy. Okay? I mean, like, my chandeliers, these are some fancy chandeliers. But I rented those. I mean, like, I'm not fancy. This is how fancy I am not, you guys. Okay, I live in Los Angeles, so every now and then I have to go to these, like, red carpet Hollywood events where you get dressed up all nice and you walk the red carpet and they take pictures of you and they go, Angela, who are you wearing? Oh, Forever 21.
I want to be dressed like you.
Okay.
Twins right now.
I will get you a matching jumpsuit. I will do it. Don't tempt me. I will.
I love Angela so much. She's one of my favorite stand-ups and people.
When did you guys meet?
I don't even know.
I don't even remember how either. Maybe through Jokoi?
Maybe.
Oh, yeah.
We call each other texty because we always get very excited to see each other.
Yeah.
We have met for coffee. We want to hang out, but both of us are constantly touring.
Right.
That we never.
So we're not really besties. We're just texties.
We text like and be like, hey, girl.
Yeah. How's your dog?
Yeah. You have a dog now.
Yeah. I almost brought him today, but I did not.
You're obsessed, right?
A little one?
Soup's obsessed. He's 14 pounds. We rescued him.
Wow.
And I've wanted a dog for 16 years.
Yeah.
But first it was, I'm too poor. I can't feed myself. So right. How am I going to feed a dog? And then I became successful. And then it was like, well, I'm too busy.
Right.
I travel too much. I can't get a dog. And it was just one of those moments where I felt like I think it's time. And also, I think the toll of being on the road for so long, I started realizing how much I needed a dog in my life.
Yeah.
Right.
And the big kicker for me when I realized I needed a dog in my life is I was on the road and I was in one of those like melancholy type moods where it's just you're in a hotel room and you're away from your family and friends. Like I have my crew, like I travel with people I love and they're my family, you know.
Right.
But it's still like sometimes you're just lonely.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Or you have anxiety because your tickets aren't selling well.
Right.
Or you have whatever it is.
The road.
It's the road. All of those feelings, right? And we cope with it or deal with it in whatever ways we do. And sometimes we don't even know what those ways are. We just like try to like ignore it. Like, okay, stop having these feelings. Like you're grateful to have this job. Like maybe you yell at yourself. Maybe that's a way you cope with it and you don't even realize
it. Right.
Yeah.
So I was in Virginia Beach, I think it was, and we got invited to like a friend of a friend's house. Like, oh, my friend lives there. You should, they'll take you to coffee.
Yeah.
And which we get a lot, but sometimes we do. And
most of the times we don't.
Yeah. You're like, I have a car.
Yeah. I could Uber to Starbucks. I'm good. Thank you, though.
They're always like, my parents will take you. Yeah. You're like, what?
Yeah, totally.
They want you to come over for dinner before your two shows.
Yeah. Exactly. And so it was one of those situations where I was like, sure, we'll go because I kind of knew them.
Uh-huh.
They weren't my friends, but I do remember them from when they used to live in LA. And so I was like, yeah, sure, we'll go meet up, whatever. We go to their house. And I was feeling this like heaviness and I couldn't quite shake it. Like my favorite songs weren't working.
Mm-hmm.
My meditations or prayer or whatever it is just wasn't working.
Yeah.
And we go to their house and she opens the door. She's like, hey, welcome. Come on in. And this little dog comes walking up to me.
Aww.
And I was like, hey, little dog. And I go and I pick it up. And as soon as I picked it up, it nestled into me and I felt all of that weight melt away.
Wow. That's amazing.
It wasn't from a prayer I just said, a meditation I just did, a happy song I just heard, me reminding myself how grateful I am for my life.
Right.
Yeah.
It came from this animal just snuggling in and sending me that love and good vibration that just melted it all away.
Yeah.
Just the idea that you could kidnap someone's pet.
Yeah. Yeah. I put it in my purse. She took it back out. But, I tried.
I totally get that.
Yeah.
I've been stressed out this week and I will pick up one of my dogs and just hold it to kind of to my heart.
Yeah.
And I feel like that peace. And I always think, it's okay that things are stressful.
Uh-huh.
I'm so lucky I have these two little animals in my house that love me always, no matter what.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
That's all they want to do is love you.
Mm-hmm. What kind of dog did you end up getting?
He's a true mutt. He's Maltese Shih Tzu Yorkie Cocker Spaniel Miniature Schnauzer.
Oh, wow.
We did his DNA test.
I was about to say, that's very specific.
Yeah. He looks like names 18 breeds.
I love that people are like, I got to know where my dog came from.
I do have to know where my dog came from.
Yeah.
To the point where I booked an appointment with a dog communicator.
No.
What?
Hilarious.
What does that mean?
Okay.
So that you can find out what your dog's feeling.
So I didn't even know this existed, right? Yeah. A good friend of mine, Amy, she was telling me how she was in New York and she was living there for 6 months. She was doing a play and her and her husband brought their dog. And it was weird. Like, his fur started changing colors and stuff. And so she's talking to her friend and her friend was like, oh my God, you have to talk to my dog communicator. And she was like, okay. So she books her appointment. She's just telling me about her appointment. And so she calls this lady and all you do is like send a picture of your dog and you get on a phone call with her.
Oh no.
And so she goes, Moose wants to know where his blue blanket is. And they're like, what? And they're like, oh, our throw blanket on our couch back home in LA is blue. And
no.
We're in New York for 6 months. Yeah. And she goes, he misses his blue blanket.
What?
And they're like, what? And then she goes, he misses the sand as well. And they're like, the sand? We've never even taken him to the beach. Like, yeah. What does she mean, the sand? Like, that's okay, whatever. Well, after the 6 months are done, they get back home. They take him to his favorite dog park, and he runs straight to the back of the park where the sand pit is, and he just starts rolling in the sand.
That is so weird.
Exactly, right? They're like, oh my God, the lady was right.
Yeah.
And but a couple other things she said was like, Moose thinks that he's very funny.
He wants to be on Netflix.
Yeah. And he says he's as smart as he needs to be.
As he needs to be. He's like, what do you expect from me?
Yeah.
He took on a real New York attitude.
Yeah, he sure did. He's like, that's what you get for taking me to New York.
I'm as good as I can be. What do you want? What do you people want?
What else do you want? I give you a hug. What else? But yeah, so I was
so
like,
you
oh my
did
God.
This?
No, not yet. I scheduled an appointment.
Oh, you're going to do it.
Like, I want to know what my dog's personality. This is how stupid I am. Whatever it is. I want to know, like, first of all, does my dog understand how much I love him?
Right.
I need him to know.
I think he probably knows.
Does he tour with you?
He does.
So you can put him in a little carrier?
Oh my God, he loves his carrier.
Right.
He, as soon as I'm going, he like getting ready for the day, he jumps in his carrier, think he's coming too.
Oh.
And I'm like, oh, not today, buddy. I'm so sorry. But yeah, like I want to know, like, does he know how much I love him? Also, what does he think about me? I need to know that I'm his number one.
Does he like my outfit?
Yeah. Yeah. Like, what do I do that he really likes so I can
What's
show him love that
favorite
way?
Favorite part about my personality.
What's his love language?
Wouldn't it be terrible if it came back that he really loves some other comedian?
Right?
who you don't like?
He's like, I don't know. I really like when he comes last special. Like, I need to know those things. And then lastly, I just want to know, like, where was he before me? Like, was he really on the streets like the shelter says he was? Or was he like a surrender from like a fan? Like, I just want to, like, where
I wonder
you?
That all the time. We've rescued my dog, too.
Both of them?
Yeah.
Oh.
Well, one, we knew where she came from because she was a puppy, but the other one they found and he was like 5. And I'm like, what was your life?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did another family, like, are they crying right now?
Right.
Oh, they're so sad, but they can't have you back.
No, hell no. They had no chance. They didn't lock the gate. That's their fault.
Sorry. He's mine now. But I'm like, were you with an Asian family?
Yeah, I want to know.
Like, did you like rice?
What language do you speak?
I have tried to talk to him in Chinese.
What?
Because we found him in a predominantly Asian community area, and so I have looked up Chinese words.
You Google Translate to your dog,
and he doesn't seem to respond. So I don't know.
So he's not Chinese.
I don't think so. Oh
my dog's too big to travel with.
Oh,
it's a big black lab.
I love labs.
Yeah, she's adorable. It's great, but you can't. I always wanted a small dog. I thought taking on tour would be fun. Daniel Tosh has his two Havanese, and he would bring them with him all all the time. That always seemed like, yeah. So is it better now that?
Oh, it's not only is it like better, like for me mentally, but honestly, it was a breath of fresh air into my 12 years of being on the road.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Like doing the same thing over yeah. and over. Like, sure, it's new material, it's new stories, but yeah. it's TSA, it's an airplane, it's can I get a water, please?
Mm-hmm. Right.
It's waiting for my luggage, it's back morning radio, mm-hmm. the hotel, the show, the meet and greet, the next show, the next meet and greet, and then Forensic Files when I get back to my room. And then, like, it's in the same thing. And then you add in, like, I knew it was going to be more responsibility, and that's what I was, like, afraid of. Like, oh, right. man, I'm going to have to, like, take it pee, like, on a layover, and, like, what if it pees on the plane? Like, oh, my God, and whatever.
Yeah.
But this added responsibility has actually been such a breath of fresh air mm-hmm. to me
right.
and to what I do that it kind of given me, like, a new lease on this road life.
Yeah. yeah.
And it's like, oh, I get to do it differently now.
Mm-hmm. And yeah, yeah.
So it's been pretty special.
That's pretty
that's
great.
Awesome. And you're on tour right now?
I'm not right now. I start up again in September.
Okay.
Yeah, doing the technically not stalking tour.
And you're so who are you technically not stalking?
My husband, always. always.
Oh,
my
really?
Husband. Oh, my
he's
God.
He's a handsome fella.
He's very handsome.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
He's like, I'm not trying to say I'm chopped liver. But when we walk into a room, nobody notices me.
Come on.
I promise
you're
you.
You're stunning.
Thank yeah. you.
Really?
You are.
But let that speak to his stunningness.
Really?
Is that no one.
He has a very captivating look. And you're as attracted to him today as you were the
yeah.
day you met.
Yeah. It's weird. Like, we'll be in the kitchen just like talking about like bills or something uh-huh. unattractive. And then like he'll move a certain way. I'd be like, ooh.
That's awesome,
I got distracted. Can you say that part again?
How long I love that.
And meanwhile, I'm like with pimple cream in my hair up in a bun. I'm like, ooh, look at you. I feel sorry for you.
You can go to Anjelah.com to find out if Anjelah will be at a city, in a city near you, coming
That's
up
right.
starting in September.
Well, thank you all for yeah. listening.
Thanks. Have a great day. Thanks, Anjelah.
Thank you.
Enjoy your day.